a node reference should be considered as a reusable container. For a self-sufficient hierarchy of nodes, a prefabricated node or a hierarchy of nodes with links to all materials, components, configured physical bodies, and other elements required for rendering and behavior simulation. Node references are generally used for instancing identical objects, offering you convenience and a number of performance optimizations. However, there are some oddities you should be aware of when working with them. Editing node references at runtime. When you make changes to the node references in the editor and apply them, all node references in the world are updated automatically. We've got two Garten pots as node references linked to the same file on the disk. Edit the node reference instance in the editor by changing the pot's material. When the changes are applied to the source file on disk, every node referenced in the world gets updated right away. Do not expect that modifying an instance of a node reference at runtime will have the same result as in Unigine Editor. Other instances of the node reference will not be updated at runtime after applying changes made to one of them. Let's try to change the material of the left node reference via code. This component checks the provided node reference and changes its material to pink when the Q key is pressed. We assign the left pot to the components field. And at a runtime, press Q to change its material. Note that the right pot doesn't change color. This is because the node reference has an internal copy of the pot loaded from the node asset on the disk that was not changed. All node references in the world created from the same node asset are just individual nodes and are not directly connected with each other. If you want to apply all changes made to a single instance to all the other instances referring to the same file asset on disk, you must save changes to the file and enable the runtime auto-reload mode. Each node reference is a unique node in the world, and therefore you can apply unique changes to each instance separately at runtime. For example, adding, deleting, and making modifications to the nodes inside the node reference. Referencing node reference content outside. Let's say we want our camera to follow the character moving around in the world. The third-person camera component requires a target node to follow. We specify a body node inside of a character's node reference as a target. Setting a node inside a node reference as a target won't work because the node references are reloaded from the disk on the world's initialization and all the links become lost. To fix this, unpack the content of a node reference in the world hierarchy and drag the desired node from the world hierarchy to the target section again. Now the link is always valid and the camera behaves as expected. Avoid referencing nodes that are stored in a node reference directly from the outside of it. For example, when manipulating nodes via tracker, creating physical joints, specifying nodes in component parameters. Such links will be lost when the world is reloaded. Node reference unpacking behavior. The content of node references can be unpacked differently depending on the current settings. We've got a node reference with a cube serving as a root node. A node reference can only have one root node. Note that the cylinder is just a direct child of a node reference and is not a part of the node reference. Let's print to the console the number of node references' children, their names, and the first child as a root node. We've got two children, the first being the root node reference, and the second is the direct child, cylinder. This happens because in a C# project, the content of a node reference is unpacked at runtime by default and is attached to the node reference as a child. But if we disable auto-unpacking, the node reference will have only its direct child from the world hierarchy because the root of the node reference is placed in parallel to it as a sibling. The auto-unpacking option for C++ projects is disabled by default to support backward compatibility. Note that the first taken child no longer returns the root of the node reference in this case. The recommended way to access the root of the node reference in both cases is to use the reference property in C# or the getReference method in C++. This way, you'll always get the correct root of a node reference, regardless of the auto-unpacking mode status. C# and C++ projects have different auto-unpacking modes set by default. That's why it's important to understand how the content hierarchy of node references is represented at runtime. Node references direct children. Physics-driven nodes inside a node reference do not affect node references direct children. The vehicle is being moved with physics, but the diesel generator in the trunk doesn't have a physical body assigned to it. You can attach the generator as a child to the frame, and it will move along with the vehicle as it is part of its hierarchy. Now, let's turn the vehicle into a node reference, and make the spare wheel a direct child of the node reference in the world hierarchy, just like we did before. The vehicle is the content of the node reference, and it does not modify its transformations. So the spare wheel being the direct child in the world hierarchy doesn't move with the truck. To fix this, we should make the wheel a child of the root node of the node reference. So we make the modifications by clicking Edit, attaching the wheel to the root node, and applying changes. Now, the wheel has become part of the node reference and behaves as expected. It is recommended to enclose all interconnected nodes in a single node reference to ensure logical and hierarchical integrity. Using node references the right way ensures integrity of instanced objects and simplifies their management, especially if they are complex and sophisticated.